Now we've had two fish up this morning already. One was definitely a marlin on the long, and unfortunately pulled the hook after about a 200 meter run. It happens. Very difficult when you've got the code zero up and you're going along at 8 knots and you can't slow the boat down. Anyway, all good. I'm sure there'll be more to come.
Now a little crayfish. Crayfish tails, rice, some beans. Like a little char. Pretty essential.
Your fresh apple tart, apple crumble, the helm, and the Ascension in the background. Also Dick, after our little creff and veggies and rice, can barely eat this. Okay, zero out. Probably the least wind we've had in the last 10 days. 10 knots, just died. It's the island in the distance. We've called into Ascension Radio and they've basically instructed us to go into the bay and contact the port control and possibly anchor in the bay. No idea what the procedure will be, but we've got to stay on board. At least they haven't chased us away, so that's a start. So yeah, I guess, I don't know if we'll have to do a COVID test again or what the story will be, but yeah. We shall see when we get there.
Just coming up to Ascension. Not quite as big as St. Helena. But ahoy, land ahead. Nice to see. A whole pot of them. Look at them right under the boat there. Leading up into Ascension. That's so beautiful. Dolphins are doing these amazing aerials. Look at them.
It's a nice greeting from the dolphins as we approach Ascension Island.
Oh, still coming up into Ascension. Gull wing in it now. Got the trapezium out. Jibbing that. And the code zero. We've got 9.7 knots, 10 knots of wind. Apparently 6 knots, 7 knots. And we're doing 7. It's not bad. Straight downwind. Marlin had been flipping quiet. We had two this morning early in the middle of nowhere in 3,000 meters of water between the banks and here. And since then, been very quiet. We had one on, smaller marlin, which came off. It could have been a spear or a white. A young, very young fish. Anyway, it came off. But that's been it so far. Lots of birds flying all over the place, but zero action.
Coming in to anchor. Ascension. The town and the beach. Not many yachts or people, not definitely not like St. Helena.
Relaxing on the anchor at Ascension. Playing a little bit of music. Always so lekker to put an anchor down after being at sea for 7 days, 10 days. Sun setting again. It's always our time to do a little bit of filming.
who knows us from J Bay. Small world. Yeah, so having a couple of drinks is so cool just to relax. Don't have any watches to do tonight. Catch up on sleep. Super difficult when you just don't get any rest. We've all done it before, but still it works on you. You get super tired of it, unfortunately. It's the part of the yachting that you don't see or don't hear about. It's not as easy as what it looks. Anyway, awesome evening. We'll catch you tomorrow, hopefully. We're gonna go ashore and go and see the guys from the immigration tomorrow, and then hopefully get cleared in. It's our first evening at Ascension. Kieran's creations.
K-lights.
The K-lights. Okay. I've lost the plot, babe. Three wines and a whiskey and I can't remember. I made them, but I can't remember what they're called. Beautiful evening. We're all getting like an omia now. We're so happy to be in flat water. Like a tune. Hopefully they're going to allow us ashore tomorrow. Now sunrise, first morning Ascension. See the turtle tracks all over the beach. Come up. Turtles all around the boat. Got pretty Valvoline last night. A good show. The wind dropped last night. We nearly died of heat. The first time we've wanted wind. This morning it's back again. Morning coffee. You can see all the fresh turtle tracks on the beach. And I'm trying to handle this quaint little house on the beach. Well, this will come out of the hand, but we'll see. So many tracks on the beach. Morning sun. See the construction going on here. They're apparently redoing the runway. Look at these big pylons. Platforms, they're bringing in big barges. These ships are actually bringing in sand, and they bring this big barge on here with a caterpillar and stuff on the back, and then load it to the hopper there, the conveyor belt, and it goes up the conveyor belt into the trucks. Now, obviously, to wherever they need it.
We've got these little trigger fish around the boat. Watch this. Look at. After a piece of rust. Just look at them. This water is so beautiful, but we've been warned there's sharks here that do not swim. So we unfortunately cannot swim.
Now, just preparing the duck to go ashore. I've got to go and take all the documentation ashore. The process getting the cover off more difficult than anything else. We actually store all our refuse in the duck. Obviously throw all the organic stuff overboard and then just keep the hard stuff. Just connecting the battery up. Bit of a process to get this all undone. Just bring it here. It off. Okay, where is it? Wobbly.
Much better with that stabilizer strap on. Yeah, but you can't, you've got that one, you've got to take off, you know. That's the one that stabilizes it. You can't really do this. Just give it a swing. Yeah, it's done. Hang on, hang on. Okay, you're unlocked. Okay. Go slow. Okay, keep yours like that, John. You can let yours go. Okay, loss, Jonah. Like yours on your loss. Okay. Give me slack there. A bit more. Okay, is it? We had some of these straps break. We almost lost the duck on the first trip. Oops, okay, you got them. Get the front ones off now. I'll say. Alright. She's running. I'll just prime the ball a bit. Apparently a massive shark problem here. They don't want us to swim. We haven't seen anything yet, but apparently it was hectic. It's gotten better. Same sort of thing that's been happening on the banks. And ducks have been attacked. Yeah, so far so good. That splashing is gonna bring a shark, John. They won't bite you. We swam with these things. Yeah, man, sit your foot in the water. Look, there's a big one.
Little did we know how prophetic these warnings would turn out to be in the days to come.
Check. Let it look. Check yourself. Let him off. Hey, bait me. I'm gonna bait. They freaking nipped me. Yeah, these things have gotten hungry since we were here last time. But geez, check how they come to your feet, eh? Yes, it's a trigger fish. They got a sharp little beak as well, eh?
On the way to Ascension Port Authority. Been in the boat for 50 days, so I'm sure it's definitely the good option.
Check the sharks attacking the kayak.
Yeah.
Maybe the time of the year, maybe the sharks, now that the fish has come here, they're going deeper now.
Yeah, we've just been advised that they need all of us on land.
Yeah, I made it to the famous Ascension Island on our way to customs. Hopefully we can get on.
Dirk doesn't even want to talk to the camera. He says we're going to walk in a straight line. There are too many rules on this place.
But the
short
end of that rule list.
Yeah, no, listen. We got told I'm not allowed to do this, not allowed to do that. Be lucky if we can take a pee here. But yeah, this is what Ascension looks like. It's not a hell of a lot. And we've just spent probably 2,500 rand to clear in here. They're giving us 3 days, which is better than nothing for sure. And we're the only ones that have been allowed to come ashore without an e-visa. So I guess we've got to be grateful for that.
Did I mention no swimming?
We're not allowed to swim. Can't go here, can't go there. So yeah. It's around the block a little bit. This is the mini mart. This wasn't here when you were here last. Dirk's still not impressed though. He's pissed off. This club.
Blow everything up.
Hey, how you doing? I'm sitting at the little pub here, having our pound beers.
2 pound beers.
2 pound beers.
No, Lion was on special for £2.
Oh, is it?
I don't know what the vintage cost.
Alex managed to get a lift down to the pier. There's Harmerton. Still standing here. Apparently they've just curtailed their operations for the COVID, but they'll be back. I'll left the boat. Oh, taking a walk back down to the pier. At least we contacted everybody, got some Wi-Fi. Awesome, man. This is Harmerton. This is a legendary old boat. This is Olaf Grimkowski's boat that they fish here. It's been standing for a while. Last time we were here, the Tateta Green Turtle, and they were maydaying to be evacuated out the water. They took a crane and took them out the water because it had pushed the rudder through the bottom of the boat. It was actually the starboard rudder.
There's
a starboard rudder that this one was pushed through. You can see there's actually a repair there. So they've got a,
looks like almost like a billfish with an American boat though. Regulator. Yeah.
26 foot.
It doesn't look like it's been in the water for a while. Looking.
Look, needs a good wash. Like everything here. It's hard to, there's nothing, everything melts here. You can look at this gravel that we're walking on. This is like a, it's just like a pumice, volcanic pumice.
No grass here. See all the turtle mounds on the beach here. It's an unbelievable amount of tracks on the beach. Oh well, we're out of shore. We're gonna get some internet, I'll load some videos tomorrow. But it sounds like we can fish a bit, so that'll be lekker. We wanted to dive, but there's a few risks involved, I think, with the sharks, so they'll just have to play it by ear. This is a platform that they're loading the sand into, this big hopper. They're loading it there with that guy standing to there, then up the conveyor belt into another hopper. Looks like another conveyor belt. All the way up. Yes, this must be costing a fortune. Stairs down to the landing area, swing on by ropes.
All right, go sideways then.
Back to the boat. What's your special romantic lunch at Ascension?
They look happy. They look impressed. No.
The internet system has crashed, so we're sitting here with vouchers and nowhere to go with them.
This is a massive operation. These guys were floating the sand from the ships. They've been here for months. Spoke to some American girls who are on the one boat that's bringing rock, that's been waiting for 3 months for the sand to be offloaded before they can offload the rock, which is even more than the sand that's being offloaded. It's a freaking hell of a freaking operation. American construction and military. So yeah, footage of the beach here. We're supposed to come and have a dry. I don't know where it is. It's not here, obviously. It's a beautiful paradise, but it's heavy construction and stuff going on here. Anyway, we've just done our internet downloads and all that. Ready to get back on board. We've got a bra set up with the conservation people here. So, interesting. Hoppers with all the sand, man. Such an amazing setup here. These big barges that are pushing these, being pushed by these tugs. Must be the most expensive sand in the world, that's for sure. Well, the duckies tie up. There's a big swell running today. So it's been pretty hectic getting on and off. Hoping our duck is all in one piece. Supplies. Yeah, so there's a bit of a view from the duck. No, it's fine. Kerry hugging the computer in the bag. Jonna taking us for a drive. Find the place for the bride tonight. I don't know where it is, maybe it's just around the corner here somewhere. Also operation this.
against the beach. So I think we're the briars tonight.
I'm gonna have a look later.
Now just coming down to the beach corner, Turtle Cove, to have a briar with some of the yachties and some of the conservation people. Looks like they're quite set up. Briar. And a little tidal pool. Just taking some footage now because it's gonna get dark soon. Ah, they got one of these little gates. Pretty cool little tidal pool. Beach. Very lekker. Fire's going. Looking cool. The Aussies are brying. It's going to be a disaster.
Yeah, it fucked right up.
Don't worry, the sapper's made the coal, so it'll work. There's Mike.
The old welding glove.
Yep. Picking the guys up off the pier for the night. We've got a good, great bry. I hear a lot of laughing and squawking. They've had a good night. The wind's actually dropped. Quite a big swell running, so yeah, it's a bit of fun and games on the ropes here. I'm gonna come in the other way.
Yeah, it was here two nights later that the duck would be viciously attacked by a shark while trying to get back to the boat.
Quite a rise and fall, yeah? No? Okay, you got it. Okay, jump up. Okay, there we go. Come to the back. Come around and come to the other side.
Lucky behind you.
Come around to this side.
Don't start your motor. You've got motor. You've got to do your
boat.
Whatever.
I've got thanks, Dan.
Cheers, Dan. Thanks a lot.
No worries, dog.
Yeah, once again we met some wonderful people and a great braai and learnt a lot about the island from the conservation guys and just generally picked up some tips on what was going on. Always good to remember to leave some lights on your boat in the evening to aid your navigation back home in the dark.
Okay, sprung, Chungalan. Go, babe. Okay. I'll give it to you. You just climb over. Give me that. Okay. Babe.
Get it. Here we go.
Hang on. Okay, now you can pull me tight. Okay. That's 100. Okay, here we go. Shot. Okay. Yeah, come back a bit, or back in front. Whoop, okay, right, front, okay, whoop. Whoop. Let's see. Right.
Green turtle.
The baby green turtle. Oh. Swimming around the boat.
It's beautiful, eh?
Just
oh, shame, man.
Of
sitting around. There's so many crabs. Let me feel it.
Take it away.
You put the light on.
You film it.
She's soft, eh?
Oh.
So soft, eh?
Oh, yeah, precious,
sir. Let him go.
He knows where the water is.
Oops.
Join us next week as we dive the shocking waters of Ascension Island and survive a terrifying shark encounter with a big Galapagos shark. An encounter that scared me absolutely out of my wits. Subscribe and join us for the rest of our stay at Ascension, and we'll see you next time. Thanks for watching.